are the source of the curiosity. Action 5 News reporter Greg Schwemm tells us tonight more about this mystery.
This anchor may be several hundred years old. Perhaps this cannon was fired before the Revolutionary War. Right now, a group of Jupiter divers are about to enter the salvaging business in hopes of determining what ship these items are from and what their historical value is. Today, the public got its first look at the artifacts, which include cannonballs and a copper kettle.
This is made back in the day when people cared about making a buck. Look at the handles on it.
The artifacts were described over the phone to a Key West archaeologist who suggested they be x-rayed. The divers believe this wreck is not logged in any nautical manuals.
They plan to properly. Today they received an order from a federal judge giving them sole authority to dive on the site and preserve whatever they find. Greg Schwemm, Action 5 News.
Gold and precious metals. A discovery valued at $500,000 lies just off the coastline of Jupiter. And tonight, the state has struck a deal that will finally lead to recovery. As Action 5's Tom Castanotis tells us this evening, digging can now begin on what may be a huge find of underwater treasure.
With that simple signing, an exciting journey can now continue. One that will take these people back hundreds of years. It started off the coast of Jupiter, when a lifeguard swimming 200 yards off the shore saw the remains of a sunken ship. But when he and friend Dominic Addario went diving, they came up with items showing the ship was more than 300 years old.
They were so excited, they went to Admiralty Court, staked their claim to it. They wanted to start digging to see what kind of ship they had. But the state said no. You see, this is a reserve. The state owns the sand. The state said you can't move it. For 3 years, they've been trying to work out.
They were able to come up with some items by sweeping away the sand by hand. But they don't know what ship they came from. This area has been called the graveyard for ships, where two or possibly three ships have gone down. With the agreement today, they can go in with heavy equipment to retrieve the artifacts.
What's important about the artifacts that we're finding is that they can be put together and assembled into a collection that can tell a story.
Under the agreement, the salvagers will get 80% of what they recover, with the rest being put on display at the Loxahatchee Historical Museum. In Jupiter, I'm Tom Castanotis, Action 5 News.
The salvagers say the first significant items could be on display as early as this summer. It could take up to 15 years, though, to recover everything.